Eyewitness News in high definition.
Next at noon, new developments out of Fresno State, what Jim Bartko's attorney is now saying about his resignation. Plus, Mariposa Grove set to reopen. We have a look inside the multi-million dollar restoration.
And weather-wise, another day in the triple digits to your full forecast straight ahead.
This is CBS 47 Eyewitness News at Noon in high definition.
Good afternoon and thank you for joining us. I'm Alex Backus. We are following several developing stories this noon hour. We first start with an update to breaking news. We're learning more now about a fatal crash in Sanger. A man in his late 30s was hit and killed early this morning at Bethel and Jenny Avenues. Police tell us he was in the road around 2:30 this morning and a woman driving by didn't see him. She is cooperating with officers. That man's identity has not yet been released. Well, right now, discussions are still ongoing at Fresno City Hall. Council members set to decide today if medical marijuana dispensaries will be allowed in the city. Fresno Police Chief Jerry Dyer was just addressing the council a few moments ago. City leaders say it's possible for all seven districts to get a medical marijuana shop. There is also talk about manufacturing facilities that cultivate cannabis. If this gets approved today, that measure would be on the November ballot. Councilman Clint Olivier says revenue would fund services like law enforcement, but the priority is providing resources for cannabis patients. We are watching this meeting. We will bring you updates as soon as they happen. We have new developments as well out of Fresno State today following conflicting reports on why Jim Bartko resigned as athletic director. The university announced he was leaving 7 months ago for personal reasons. Now Bartko says he was forced out. Fresno State said they paid him $75,000 in severance pay. Now, if there is a lawsuit, experts tell us it will come down to the agreement which mutually ended the contract.
The sole question is whether there was any claim that relates to Fresno State that does not fall within that settlement agreement.
Bartko's attorney sent us a statement a short time ago. It reads, Fresno State has publicly released documents suggesting that Mr. Bartko voluntarily and thoughtfully resigned and released any claims against the university. For a release of claims to be valid, the release must be knowing and voluntarily signed without duress. We intend to ask the court to decide whether that happened here. We don't think it did. New at noon, State Attorney General Javier Becerra has announced $67 million in debt relief for former Corinthian students. You'll remember Corinthian operated several colleges, including Heald Business College in Fresno. It shut down back in 2015, accused of misleading students and federal investigators on rates for job hiring. Thousands of students have been fighting for student loan relief since that shutdown. Well, family separations are surging at the border amid the Trump administration's zero tolerance policy. One public defender says about 500 children have been separated from their families since May. Now, this is a look inside the Casa Padre shelter in Brownsville, Texas. The federal government opened that shelter for a controlled media visit yesterday. It is the largest migrant children's shelter here in the U.S. Nearly 1,500 boys between 10 and 17 are housed inside. And here's what one attorney had to say.
One of the women that I interviewed today told me that she was breastfeeding her daughter when the government took her daughter from her. And when she resisted, she said that was when they put handcuffs on her.
Republicans in Congress have struck a deal to vote on immigration next week. They will address issues including family separation. There are also new developments in the Golden State Killer case. The suspect, also known as the Visalia Ransacker, is former Exeter police officer Joseph D'Angelo. DNA test results have cleared D'Angelo in the 1978 murders of a woman and her four-year-old son in Southern California, specifically in Simi Valley. Now, dozens of other victims may be eligible for compensation. Macy Jenkins reports.
Having caught him has actually made me think about the crime all the time, which is essentially like opening an old wound.
In March 1980, Charlene and Lyman Smith were murdered in their Ventura home. Daughter Jennifer Carroll was just 18 at the time. Their suspected killer, the East Area Rapist. A traumatic moment for her and fellow victims. Now the state of California wants to compensate them for what they've been through.
I'm actually really thrilled with the idea.
Under the 2018 budget bill, the state would provide victim compensation benefits for those who directly or indirectly suffered emotional harm or financial losses due to the crimes committed by the East Area Rapist. And that includes harm incurred while preparing to testify.
One of the biggest challenges has been already is being as folks having enough money to get to California to participate.
And with victims all over the country, those costs add up.
I have not asked for any money, but I certainly might consider it.
Carol says the money could also cover counseling costs. The California Victim Compensation Board says the amount of money each victim receives will be determined on a case-by-case basis. The board has already gotten inquiries from 25 victims in four counties, including Sacramento.
I don't think there is an amount of money that can replace what we all lost. That's ridiculous. But if the money allows us to heal or get counseling or participate in a way that gives us closure, that's powerful.
That was Macy Jenkins reporting. We are turning now to weather on this Thursday. We have another day of triple digits on tap, but we will be cooling down for the weekend. Anthony Bailey has a first look at our forecast.
Yeah, that's right. Of course, Alex, we're looking at temperatures not quite as hot as yesterday. Clear skies across the area right now, and our sky cam in Fresno looks pretty good for us. Temperatures, though, of course, we are definitely feeling the heat. A quiet conditions on live pinpoint Doppler radar, but you can see we're already in the 90s for Fresno and parts of the South Valley. Even in the Shaver area, we're up near that 80 degree mark. Light winds on the way for us, and we will see temperatures back into the 80s for your Father's Day weekend. I'll explain more about it coming up in your full pinpoint forecast.
Sounds great. Thanks, Anthony. Well, Mariposa Grove in Yosemite National Park will open to the public tomorrow for the first time in 3 years. It has been closed for a $40 million restoration project. And today, the park celebrated with a ribbon-cutting ceremony that ended just a few moments ago. John Blackstone is at Mariposa Grove with a look at the makeover.
Here in Yosemite National Park, the Mariposa Grove has trees so big, it's hard to fit them all in our picture. But a $40 million restoration project is making it better than ever to see these trees in person.
Completely restored, and it's just a more tranquil and have a more serene experience.
Frank Dean is president of the Yosemite Conservancy, a nonprofit that raised $20 million for the restoration of the grove. The National Park Service put in another $20 million. How is this different than what was here 4 years ago?
Fuel station for the trams. So now what you have is the first view you get as you see it framed by two or three giant sequoia trees.
The goal was to take out many modern additions, returning the grove to a more natural state, removing pavement and parking lots, restoring streams and wetlands, and minimizing the damage from cars and people getting too close.
You can see that people have come up to this tree before and feel the bark and maybe pull a strip of bark off. So if we have thousands of people coming to visit the grove, we just can't allow people to come up and touch the trees anymore.
Sue Beatty, a restoration ecologist with the National Park Service, helped plan the makeover, including new fences to protect the tree's bark from too many hands and raised walkways to protect the roots from too many feet. The latest steps in that protection were being completed just in time for today's ribbon cutting. But while workers were taking care of details on the ground, visitors will be looking up, way up.
And it looks beautiful up there. That was John Blackstone reporting. The Inspector General is releasing a report today on the FBI's handling of the Hillary Clinton email scandal. The investigation has been ongoing now for 18 months. That report is expected to be critical of former FBI Director James Comey and former Attorney General Loretta Lynch. Final preparations are underway now in Washington for tonight's annual congressional baseball game. House Majority Whip Steve Scalise will be back on the field tonight. You'll remember 1 year ago, he was shot and gravely wounded during a team practice. He has spent months recovering, he still is, and he finally returned back to work last fall. That game starts in a couple of hours at Nationals Park. Both Republicans and Democrats take part, and the money raised there benefits several charities. Coming up on this Thursday edition of Eyewitness News at Noon, the 2018 World Cup officially underway in Russia. We will take you there where the excitement is palpable among tens of thousands of fans. And calling all you last-minute shoppers, do you still need something for Dad? We are breaking down the